Okay, so we're going to upgrade HA pair now, and we're going to do it whilst we're going to video this as well. So this is a host that's running behind the firewalls, and we're going to monitor the amount of pings that we lose, and we're going to try and lose as few as possible so that when you're in a production environment and you're upgrading HA firewalls, you can say with confidence that that there's not going to be any kind of outage, or if there is, it's going to be a small blip. Okay, so we'll just drop that down to the side, and we'll just keep monitoring as we go. Okay, so to do this, what we're basically going to do is we're going to upgrade the active first. We're going to go through the prerequisites, download the software, make sure the dynamic updates are all good, and then we're going to monitor, say, our pings to see and make sure we don't have any failovers. So this is the active at the minute, as you can see, and this is the passive. And if we have a look on here, we can see that everything's fine, everything's in sync. If ever you're doing any kind of upgrade to HA peers, you always make sure they're in sync first, and they've got the same dynamic update versions, which they should have anyway, and so on. Okay, now the first thing I always like to do before doing any of this is just to make sure that we're not going to have any configuration sync between the two. So just disable config sync for the minute. Commit, and it does always say you only see it on one, but I like to do it on both. And just whilst we're here as well, just point out that what we don't want to happen as well, if you have preemptive, so if you have preemptive set up, which is when the firewall comes back up, as long as its device priority is lower than its peer, it will come back online, it will come back active. We want to remove that as well. Now, I don't actually have that configured here, but if I did, I'd want to remove that as well. So make sure to remove the preemptive as well. Okay, so once these have committed, which it looks like it's doing now, now pings are still going, obviously, just pinging Google through this firewall. Okay, so that's completed, so now we're going to pin that. Right, so we're going to go to the basic idea is we're going to download the software to here, and then we're going to cause a failover to HA2. When we cause a failover to HA2, then we're going to see that we're working then on the passive, and then we upgrade the passive, and then hopefully when that comes back up, everything should be fine. We should be able to fail back, and then we're going to make sure that our actual infrastructure only changes at the last minute when we want it to, because everything that's being run through is going to be the same. Okay, so this is the active peer. Going to go to software. Hit check now. On this one, it's already done, but you'd always hit check now just to make sure that you've got the latest versions. Now, these are running on 10.1.4. We are going to go to 10.1.2H2. And I'm not going to sync it to my HA peer because I don't want to sync anything to it. I want full control over this, although what I could do is download this and then sync it to the HA peer so that I don't have to go through this process on the other firewall. Okay, so now that's downloaded, it's going to preload it into the software manager, as it says, which means it's in the software manager, means we can then work with it and manipulate it. Also, if we look down the side here, we can see the release notes. That's a link that will take you straight to the release notes for whatever version you're going to. Usually worth checking, certainly around about the lower versions, I guess around about sort of 1.8 or sort of 0.9. See this last. These are the maintenance releases, so they are, I guess, up around about 8.9, you're probably okay. The preferred version at the minute, at the time of making this video, is 10.19H3, but we're going to go to 10.18H2, okay? Right, so we're going to close that. Right, so now we know it's downloaded and we're ready to install it, so what we're going to do is we are going to just come back to setup. Operations. Now, if all this goes completely wrong, what we want to do is we want to save a named configuration snapshot, so pre-upgrade. Okay, and then we're going to export that. So we're going to export the save named configuration snapshot. So that means now that we've got a copy of that pre-upgrade, which is one for some unknown reason. But we've got pre-upgrade, which you'd have to edit the one before you put it back in. Brackets aren't allowed. But also, just in case your firewalls are running Global Protect or they have an authentication port or anything that needs a certificate, we also want to export the device state for this firewall. Okay, so now I've exported both of those and I've got those safe. And that means that if anything goes wrong, I'll be able to load the import the device state back into the firewall, and then import the save name configuration snapshot, and then I've got all the certificates and I've got all the XML, and then I can restore the firewall should I need to. Right, so in HA now, we're going to come to our HA configuration, operational commands. We're going to suspend this local device for high availability, which we've done, which means now if I come back here, I can check. We dropped one ping during the failover. So I've got suspended, user requested. This should now be active. You can see we've got our active there. And because it was suspended, user requested, we've got that as a status there. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to, if we did that now, we could just make it functional for high availability again. It will do that by default when we reboot it, or at least it always has done. So now we're going to simply install the software into this now suspended passive firewall. Okay, so now that the software has been installed, the device wants to reboot. So it reboots so that it can load into the new software. So we're going to click yes. And of course, there's no disruption to our pings because we're not running on this firewall anymore. So when the firewall takes its time and reboots back up, we should see it come back up and there should be a version mismatch. However, the HA should still be intact. So as long as the HA is intact, we can then fail across from the now active to our now new passive. Ensure everything's going, check the session table, make sure sessions are building. We can do that before we fail as well to make sure the sessions are being synchronized across. Once the sessions are up, we know that everything is as good as it can be. Fail across should be maybe one or two drop pings. Majority of applications can handle that, so that shouldn't see any outage for you in your environment. Okay, so now it's rebooted, so now we can log into it and still not lost any pings. Okay, we're not going to save the password because I don't. And if we look on here, we should see now that we have everything is still up. This one is still active, the other one's still passive, that's all good. But it is showing there's a PANOS version mismatch, as well as a plugin VM series mismatch. So we can assume that the VM series plugin, because of course these are all VMs, has been upgraded as we've gone through, and that's fair enough. And then on this side as well, we've got that. So if we look to the monitor tab and we go to the session browser, we should see sessions, specifically the ICMP, that we have running, and other internet sessions as well from our firewall running through this one, which we can see. And then we have our host, which is here, which is the 172.16.128.2. That's our host that's got the ping running. Okay, so we know we've got sessions building up. If we look on here, we can even compare it, say okay, what kind of sessions have we got here. Expect to see the sessions on here, so ping undecided. Okay, so that looks good to me. That looks to me like we've got the sessions building up as we need to, and we know now that we've got our firewall is configured and we've got a OS mismatch, which makes sense. Okay, so now what we're going to do is now we're going to fail across. So we're going to come to our HA2. We are going to fail across on here. We're going to suspend this device now. And then we're just going to check and make sure that HA1 is active, which it is. And so now we've got suspended, user requested, because as I said before, once the firewall comes back up, it reboots up and its HA functionality is enabled again. You can also see, just out of interest, in the logs at the bottom, we can see it's accepted the public key because our HA is it's encrypted between the two. And we also noticed that we dropped one ping during that time. That's more than acceptable. Okay, and then if we look back on our session browser now, we can see the session browser there. We can also see that the application is now because we've got everything running through it, and we can see that we've got our pings running from our 128.2 and so on, our net BIOS stuff. That's what all that traffic was coming out from my from my other network and hitting the front end of, well, it's a broadcast, so it's hitting the front end of this. Okay, so now we're going to do exactly the same again, and we're going to, I'm not going to make the local device functional for high availability, because as I said, it will do that by default. That also means that, of course, whilst we're messing about with this one and we're doing whatever we're doing with this one, that also means that we don't stand a chance of causing a disruption, because this literally isn't now participating. It does mean you've got reduced resiliency, however, during that time. Okay, so in the software, so because this firewall has never had the check now button pressed, it's never been allowed to download its update. It says there's no update information available. It simply means it's got no update information here, so we're going to check now. At this point now, it will reach out to Palo Alto Networks and it will pull down its software versions, and we know for a fact that we want 10.18H2, so we are going to do that, click that, and we're going to continue to download. Now, of course, this, you would have saved time by doing it the other way. If you'd have synced to HA Peer, that that software would have already been available, and we'd have saved a bit of time, but through the magic of videos, you won't lose any time over it anyway. Okay, so I'll pause the video then, just come back to it when that's downloaded. Okay, so this again is loaded into the software manager, preloading software manager, so we know what we're going to do now. We're just going to go close, and we are going to hit install. And now it's going to start installing the software, and it will do exactly the same as the other one did. It'll go to the, do you want to reboot now? And so far during the whole process, I think we've dropped 3 pings so far. So it's going really well. I'll pause the video here again, and then we'll reboot it. And then when we come back up, we'll see you should have a version match, all is well. And then we'll just restore the config sync. And then once config sync's restored, then the files will be back as they were before we started. Okay, so now this is rebooted, so we're going to log back into it. And even if we check on here now, so if we check on the active, this should now come back up and should be looking good. And it is looking good. We've now got no version mismatch. This is still active. HA2 is still passive. And if we look on HA2, it's accepted the key again, so that's all good. So it's got its key, it knows that its SSH, of its encryption is up. And this is passive, everything matches. So now we're simply just going to go in, going to redo the enable config sync. Okay, so we're going to hit there. Commit that. And there, whilst that's committing, we can check on here and make sure that everything is going as it looks like it's going. So we look on the session browser. Obviously, of course, we're going to get application on this side and so on, because the traffic isn't actually running through this file. We know this is just a session, that's all the session details, which are here. So we know that it's a flow, it's in the init stage, and we have all the session ID and everything like that, so this firewall can take over if it needs to, where it's flowing from and to. This one in particular is to a broadcast address. That's a really bad example. We haven't got anything going from the other one at the minute, because it's ICMP. So we'll just check on the tasks there. Again, you can always check, hit the tasks at the bottom, you can check that. So that is now nearly committed. Case that commit is complete, as you can see, and then we're going to go over to here. We're just going to enable the config sync on here. So we've got config sync going both ways. That's done. So once that's done, then now we know our sessions are building. We've dropped about 4 pings across the entire thing. And we can then just do a quick failover test as well, just to check and make sure. And then we'll probably drop another ping or something during that failover test. and then that's it, then that's completed, then you've upgraded, you've had no downtime, everything has worked as it should do. Through Panorama is pretty much the same process, other than you can do it differently. So you can context switch, or you can have separate paths open, separate browser windows open to the firewalls. You can push the software down to the device and reboot the device from Panorama as well. And we'll sort of look further into that as in the Panorama videos. But now this is nearly committed. Okay, but we are happy. We're happy the traffic's flowing. We're happy that everything is going as it should be. If I look at this one, so we've got ping, undecided. This is the active, we've got ping, 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 ping. SSL firewalls, the host isn't doing that much, to be honest. We've got like miss update, and that's on discard because it's not allowed because at the minute the rule base on here. So that's an interesting thing. So this is in actually discard flow. So this is being discarded. So you look at this at the drop section of a packet capture. It is there, but because the rules, you can see it's MS update, it's being identified as, and the rules are only allowing these. So it's doing its job. Okay, we'll just check and make sure that is finished. That is finished. And so now we're just going to check failover. So we're going to come to operational commands on the active. And I'm going to suspend it and say, yes, absolutely, we do. And then we, looks like we've dropped a ping, request timed out, and then we come straight back. Okay, so now this here is, this will be suspended, user requested, and the other one active. And this is where, so now we've done that. This is now active, and it will show us the status of the other suspended user requested. So now what we'll do is, because we know everything is all good, we're going to make this device functional for high availability again, and then our status will change here, which is initial leaving suspended state. Come to here. And then we've got local passive, and this now should have changed to just simply passive. And that's it. So now we've done it. We've dropped, say, 4 or 5 pings across the entire thing, including testing the failover and fail back once it's done. And our firewalls are upgraded to 10.18H2 from 10.14.